Where the hell is Bella Abzug? She's stashed away in the toilet of a guest room at the Summit Hotel on the Upper East Side of Manhattan as she waits to be declared the first ever female senatorial candidate from the great state of New York. Where the hell else would I be?
Hi, I'm your Audible editor, Abby West, and I am delighted to be here today with Harvey Fierstein, the writer and performer of Bella Bella, our new Audible original about Bella Abzug. Welcome.
Thank you. Bella Bella is about Bella Abzug. She was a fabulous politician and a fabulous civil rights lawyer. She was this incredible woman. But there was this one thing in her life where she ran for Senate, and they sort of stomped her out. And I thought it was kind of fascinating to see how we treat women in politics. Everyone I know, every nervous cholera shoved into a hotel room. My dear friend Shirley is strewn across the double bed wailing, "Why is this taking so long?" She's an actress. They get emotional. "Relax, Shirley," I told her. "I have never entered a race I didn't win." She locks herself in the bathroom.
Yes, I love that conceit.
And then she talks to the audience. And she says to the audience, you know, that they're make-believe. It's easier to talk to a bunch of strangers than to face your friends. And I'm hoping that what we recorded today will sound like I'm talking just to you.
How did you come up with the conceit of her being locked in the bathroom?
So I started writing the play, having this idea to place it on that night. And I called her a press secretary. I said, "So you'll all be like in the living room and she's in the bedroom." He goes, "There was no bedroom. They gave us this tiny hotel room. There was a bed and there was the bathroom. That was it." So that made me laugh. And I thought, write an entire play in the toilet. The character is slowly coming to the realization that her world's falling apart, that it's not going to happen, and it's incredibly painful. And I did not write it that way because Harold Holzer said to me, "She is Annie. The sun will come out tomorrow. You cannot write her down."
She really sounds like someone that everyone needs to know and be more aware of right now. What do you hope people are going to take away from this?
That we really do need to treat women differently, that we need to stop treating them differently. At the same time, women aren't free to travel as much as men are, to stay late at the office and all that, because men do not take the responsibility.
And let's not even talk about the emotional labor part.
Well, that's something different. That's something different again. But the idea that women don't respect women, and I hear it, when do we stop tearing each other apart? When do we start looking at what they have to offer and not what we can criticize? When I started this whole senatorial campaign, a pollster handed me a survey and was surprised when I threw it back in his face. "Would you vote for a woman if she was qualified?" Now, why the hell does a woman have to be qualified if a man only has to be a man?
Why was it important for you to play her?
I thought of women to play the role. I started saying, what am I going to get out of somebody just getting up there and making believe they're Bella? And then on a whole different political level, I thought to myself, you're a man writing a feminist piece. If I then put those words into a woman's mouth, am I not doing to her what has been done to women through history, men speaking through women, turning them into puppets? If I want those words said, and I believe enough in those words, then I have to have the guts to get up and say them myself. The wonderful thing when we did the play, lots of her friends came to see it, Marlo Thomas and Lily Tomlin and Gloria Steinem and all. They said, you know, obviously you're a man, you came out on the stage, and within a couple of minutes, that just disappeared, and there was our Bella. Even her daughters said that to us. Even her daughters said, you know, and there was my mother.
That had to feel really good.
It felt wonderful. So I'm wondering what this is going to be like, just hearing it and saying to yourself, I'm listening to this inner monologue of this person going through this stuff.
Harvey, thank you so much for talking to us about Bella Bella. We're fascinated and can't wait to hear more about Bella Abzug and someone we should know. So thank you. You can find Bella Bella on audible.com.